Computer scientists solve problems that can't be solved in just a few minutes, a few hours, or even weeks. They usually take months or years and a team of computer scientists. To work on a problem for so long, it's really important to break it into bite-sized pieces. In computer science, sometimes this is called iterative development, where we keep making something more and more complicated and closer to our final goal. Check out these examples that you can try. Imagine this is our goal. We want to have Scratch draw this complicated picture. This is too complicated to just sit down and write, so we'll break it up into pieces. Let me show you some of the pieces that will build the skills so that drawing something like this seems like no big deal. Let's walk backwards through the process. Drawing something like this would be pretty easy if I had a way to draw something that looked like this, but was all the same color. Check out this program that I drew. If I had something that worked like this, I could just change the color of the pen in between each petal and get the next picture. But how do I make one of these petals? I want to be able to make a petal that looks about like this. To do that, I can play around with the pen a bit. I'll move the character up to the top, and then I can draw something like this. Here, I've made the pen size a bit bigger, and I did something like a dotted line. Except instead of moving the character with the pen down, what I did is I just put the pen down, and that drew a dot. Let's look at what it looks like when I make these dots bigger and bigger. I'll move the character down. That's looking closer. Imagine if I just took smaller and smaller steps in between each of these dots. Can you imagine how, if it was smushed together a bit, it might look more like a petal? In the end, we know that we're going to need to change the color of the pen in between each petal. To practice that, I could draw a row of these dots and change color in between each one. Let's look. Cool. Let me clear the screen. From here, you can imagine how I can draw a single petal, just taking smaller steps in between each of the dots. You can imagine I can draw many of those petals just by turning in between each one. And then if I just change the color of the pen each time, let me clear it, I can draw my final flower. So through simpler problems that sometimes don't look much like the final product, I can develop skills that will help me be able to tackle big projects.